I'm John Davis, tutor in contemporary film and theatre at Morley College. Welcome to this latest Waterman's No Ticket Required film club. On March the 8th, I will be joined by Rod Rule from the British Film Institute to talk about the work of British director Steve McQueen. And we'll be discussing Lover's Rock from his series of five TV features, Small Axe. So let's have a look at the trailer. The director is Steve McQueen, or should I say Sir Steve McQueen. He was knighted in 2020. And he's a local Waterman's boy, being born and brought up in Ealing. I, like many people, found his emergence as a mainstream film director quite a surprise, having known him through his art. He won the Turner Prize in 1999. But he'd always used film in his practice. One of his first prize winners was Deadpan, based on the famous Buster Keaton stunt. More of that later. In 2008, his first feature film, Hunger, premiered at the Cannes Film Festival. It was intense and political, based as it was on the 1981 Irish hunger strikers, and in particular Bobby Sands, played by a relative newcomer at the time, Michael Fassbender. In 2011 came Shame, a psychological study of a sex addict, again with Michael Fassbender, who was asked to give an extraordinary performance, but at least didn't have to lose a lot of his body weight, as he had done for Hunger. In 2013, his epic 12 Years a Slave was a box office and critical success. It earned three Academy Awards for Best Picture, Best Adapted Screenplay, and Best Supporting Actress. Chiwetel Ejiofor starred as Solomon Northup, a free American in 1841 who becomes enslaved and has to fight for his freedom against huge odds. In 2018, he demonstrated his wide range with Widows, a complicated and feminist heist movie based on the 1980s TV series and starring Viola Davis. And in 2020, he created five whole feature films in the BBC's Small Axe series. Small Axe consists of five different films, all of which work individually, but knit together to give a panorama of Black British life in the 60s to 80s. Mangrove, the first one, looked at the notorious trial and institutional corruption that faced a group of Black Caribbean Notting Hill residents in the late 1960s. Red, White and Blue looked at the tensions and prejudice a young Black police officer, played by John Boyoga, faced in the Metropolitan Police. Alex Wheatle, starring Cheryl Cole, as a Black British novelist who was sentenced to prison following the 1981 Brixton riots. And the fifth part, Education, is based on an unofficial policy that some London councils had in the 1970s. Of transferring a disproportionate number of Black children from mainstream education to schools for the so-called educationally subnormal. And this is close to McQueen's heart, who faced prejudice in his own education, being discounted as someone only suitable for manual trades. But our choice is Lover's Rock, the second in the series. It's a love story set against an evening of a reggae house party in West London. With us to discuss it will be Rod Rule from the BFI, who was with us for our discussion on disobedience and, undeterred, in fact quite enthusiastic, will be asking us to think about questions like, why were blues parties important to that generation of first and second Caribbean generation in London? And are there any similarities between these parties and other cultural group parties and gatherings of the time, like Irish Ceilidhs in Kilburn and Cricklewood? Who is the filmmaker addressing and speaking to in these films? What are our thoughts about the film's period detailing? And what are our thoughts on how the BBC commissioned the Small Axe series for their primetime slot on a Sunday night? During this whole period of feature filmmaking, McQueen has continued to work as an artist and been active in many films, but to go back for a moment to one of his early works, Deadpan. Sadly, none of McQueen's art films are freely available on the internet. So let's look at the work of Buster Keaton that inspired him in one of his early films. And this is what you do now.